Today's a big day. Until now, it's just been trying to gain reliability, trying to make sure that everything's working as it should. It's kind of the first almost performance testing that we've been doing with the Bosch EBS. Making sure that failures are in place in case something happens, and you know, trying to run through anything that could possibly go wrong in reality. For me, it's definitely the most interesting day so far.
So the ultimate goal for the testing that we're doing now is to run the system long-term, do a full race simulation, and have no issues. So we just want to do a race before we do a race. And once we can do that without any surprising faults, we're good to go for Indy. So we did the test last week successfully. We checked all the fault cases, and now we're just getting runtime, and we're finally doing performance tuning. Right there, you're asking for 45.
Yeah.
But it doesn't actually get it to you until this point. Which,
and like, what's the time on that?
From the roll in, it's 90 milliseconds.
Yeah. But I feel like sometimes I go in like really hot and I'm like, that was weird. And then the next time I'll be like over slowed and I feel like I did like virtually the same squeeze.
Gotcha.
Comparing a normal hydraulic brake system that you'd have in your car to a brake-by-wire EBS system, the main differences on it are the source signal input for it. So on your foot, you're providing all of the energy for that braking system and how it's stopping the car to the calipers. But with our brake-by-wire system, we take an input signal and then we modulate based on that and provide the rest of the energy electronically.
So the EBS devices are a brake blending module by design. So they're originally a production part that Bosch manufactures for a couple of road cars that have electric and hydraulic braking. So you need some way to blend the hydraulic braking with the regen capability of the electric motor. To do that, it interrupts the driver brake apply and sends it to a simulator circuit that simulates what the brake pedal should feel like. So the driver shouldn't feel anything different if it's tuned properly. And then the system applies whatever brake pressure the system says that it should have with the electric torque. So the driver is essentially, rather than applying brake pressure, they're applying a brake request. We're using it in a little bit different application where we are applying all of the brakes with the EBS system, so that's taking quite a bit of work on our side to make happen, but we're getting there.
This is my throttle paddle. So pretty simple, pull it towards the wheel for full throttle, off. Standard upshift, downshift, so it's the same for my teammates and myself. The first thing that might be different than another Elantra NTCR car is this on the backside. That's my brake ring. So I pull that in to apply the brakes, and yeah, that's pretty much it. And then the Bosch EBS does its own magic down here. These six buttons, that's standard on all Hyundai Elantra NTCR cars, but this is the added stuff that we have for our Bosch EBS. So the B up and B down is my brake bias, forward and backwards. This dash over here is the health of my brake system. I can see my brake bias, the level of difficulty that I want to apply the brakes. My goal from this journey is to try to get the exact same feeling that my teammates have with their hydraulic brake system, but just up with my hands. And I can't wait to race it for the first time at IMS.
He's had this vision on exactly what he wants that to be, what he wants it like from when he squeezes the wheel, and even from what it looks like in additional race cars moving forward throughout his career.
Robbie is a true professional. It's very clear, having worked with multiple other teams, manufacturers, drivers, like he is at that elite level. He's very technical, which helps a lot.
We work with a lot of different drivers, so we are pretty accustomed to them being very particular with what they want, which is great from our perspective, right? We want to not have ambiguity of what we think it should be like behind the wheel. He knows exactly what he wants, and he's working to push the whole team to reach that.
Yeah, it's been a really cool experience being able to work with the Bosch guys. I've learned a lot about what Robert has to deal with from a day-to-day. It's extremely impressive, you know.
We need laps, we need miles to prove reliability for what we're accessing from his braking capabilities, from his master cylinders, for his brake system, into mine.
This morning, we went through some faults. Basically, I would be going down the track, unplug a wire, plug it back in and make sure everything would come back to normal, you know? I can still stop the car with my foot if it were to fail, but mentally, like, stopping with your hands, it's a completely different ballgame. Basically, I just had to reset my whole entire brain, you know? It's a really weird feeling going into the corner and knowing to stop the car, you're gonna have to squeeze instead of push with your foot. And every corner is different, like from the rights to the left-handers, you have to have, position your hands in different ways.
Are you always the person who flips?
Yes.
Okay, all we want is like just the flipping with the engine on and that, just to make sure that everything activates or deactivates as we'd expect with a hot car.
They both have to coexist and they both have to work properly. And from everything from reliability of flipping a switch from hand controls to foot controls. When Harry and I are doing a pit stop, doing a driver change, if I get in or get out, Harry will have to switch the toggle. Because the way I position my feet, I actually put my right foot on the throttle pedal.
This is my second year working with Robert, and man, it's just been a blast. I've learned so much. He's so articulate and just like, he's a very smart and clever guy. Taught me loads, just to like, I don't know, attitude, day-to-day life, on and off the track. It's been a real pleasure working with him.
What'd you run?
108.8, Chief.
Cat, get to know.
Save me some tires.
The system was designed for a foot brake. The forces of a leg, significantly higher than the forces of the hand. So like the system was sized for leg force and specifically for a single axle. We originally had a concept for it years ago, but varying factors, one, the workload of introducing the GTP cars was its own beast, so just no one had time to dedicate to anything else, but it was actually Jordan Krell who originally had the idea, like, oh hey, we have this module that can actuate brakes at a driver command. Could we do hand controls with this?
Been thinking about this for a long time, like probably 3 or 4 years. I don't even know that Robbie knows it. But I was actually at his first TCR test at Mid-Ohio. He was testing with a system. The team actually came up. I was not doing brake system work. I was doing some other work at the test. And they're like, do you guys have something?
And it kind of spiraled from there. And you know, to be here doing it right now is an absolute dream project to work on. So like, yeah, we got very lucky that we got buy-in from multiple key players, both within Bosch and outside.
So for me, this is, I call it like my mantelpiece project, and I always tell everyone on the team, like, this is gonna be the project that you tell your kids about and your grandkids about that you did that. Like, it's really cool to make race cars go fast and win trophies, but to actually have an effect on the human side and being able to enable someone to further their career and unlock their full potential, like, it doesn't get much better than that.
That's where you ended up with is something that had
seven, like gain seven was
where yeah, exactly. So it's kind of hard to see from this map structure, but
I'm going significantly quicker than the first time we were here. When we were here last, I don't want to say it was premature, but we probably should have been more on just a straight line testing back and forth. The use of a track was almost redundant. It's always great to be on a track, of course, but you know, we're really just doing almost like a systems check of the car and to where we were then to where we are now. A lot of hard work's gone in to everyone at Bosch and everyone at Reinhardt Autosport to get to this point. So I'm happy with the system. I'd be ready to go race it this weekend if we had a race this weekend.
So the goal of this test was to be able to kind of put a check on that the system is reliable and safe and working how we're expecting it to work. And we've been able to do that.
I mean, I think short term, what's next is to win the last two IMSA Mission Pilot Challenge races. You know, it's going to be an uphill battle. We're second in points right now, and hopefully come away with another championship. Moving into the future, you know, obviously everything's uncertain, nothing's clear in motorsport, but my ambitions are to try to get to the IMSA WeatherTech Series in GTD and frankly show what I can do on a bigger stage doing the 24 Hours of Daytona and 12 Hours of Sebring. You know, there's so many cool races in IMSA that I just love to be a part of, and that's definitely the goal.
The system, the way we've designed it, is meant to be transferable. Like, we could take what we're doing here and we could apply it to a GTP car that already has an ABS module in it.
It'll have to be adapted on the input signal and the steering wheel and all that perspective. But when you look at it from the components and being able to be applied to other cars and different classes, even different types of racing, it's not quite plug and play, but very close to being able to integrate within other cars.
Hopefully it creates a runway for anyone with a disability. I think the opportunities are endless. For me, this is just step one. You know, now I have a brake system that frankly I can take with me to higher and faster cars, and I know that the system will cope and will be able to handle those demands.